Good morning and welcome to Grace United Methodist Church. We are located in South Denver, just west of I-25 in Yale, but we are also located online, and you can find us on Facebook and YouTube at Denver Grace UMC. This morning is the fifth Sunday in the 50-day Easter season, and we continue to lift up new life offered through stories and people's experiences of Christ's resurrection. Today is also Mother's Day. Many families will honor and celebrate mothers, though perhaps in some different ways this year in the COVID season. Others may have complicated or difficult feelings and emotions on this day. Wherever you are on the spectrum, we invite you to breathe deep, to bring yourself fully to this time as we gather for worship. May you look for a word or insight from God as we share in prayer, music, meditation, reflection, and connection. Let us know you're here on the comments on Facebook or YouTube, and welcome to Grace.
Good morning, Grace and friends, and happy Mother's Day to all. My name is Janice Gibson, and I am coming to you this morning from my living room. In fact, I'm sitting in a recliner in my living room that is also a rocking chair. I thought rocking chairs might be something good to talk about on Mother's Day, because many of us have been rocked by our mothers or our fathers as we were growing up, or we have rocked our own children in rocking chairs. Rocking chairs have been around for almost 2.5 centuries, and there is something about the motion of a rocking chair that is so soothing and calming. They have found that rocking chairs can help ease anxiety. They can improve your mood. And so I don't know if your house has a rocking chair or not, but during these uncertain times that we are living through, it might be nice to spend a few moments each day in a rocking chair, just rocking, relaxing, and calming. So rocking chairs are not the only important part of being a parent. There's lots of love that is involved with that too. And so as I'm rocking, which I'll stop now, I don't want to get anyone sick, I want to read you a book today that involves rocking chairs and love. In fact, I feel this book gives us three wonderful messages about love that Jesus tried to teach us and is always showing us in his life. The first message is that love reaches out and finds you wherever you are. Love connects us. It connects us and brings us close. And the last one is that love lives on. Love keeps going and going. It never stops. So let's enjoy this book, Love You Forever. It may be a book that you've heard before. It's been around since the early 90s. It is written by Robert Munch, and the pictures that I will show you are by Sheila McGraw. Love You Forever. A mother held her new baby and very slowly rocked him back and forth. And while she held him, she sang, I'll love you forever, I'll like you for always, as long as I'm living, my baby you'll be. Looks like she's in a rocking recliner, like I am. The baby grew. He grew and he grew and he grew. He grew until he was 2 years old, and he ran all around the house. He pulled all the books off the shelves. He pulled all the food out of the refrigerator, and he took his mother's watch and flushed it down the toilet. Sometimes his mother would say, this kid is driving me crazy. But at nighttime, when that two-year-old was quiet, she opened the door to his room, crawled across the floor, looked up over the side of his bed, and if he was really asleep, she picked him up and rocked him back and forth. And while she rocked him, she sang, I'll love you forever, I'll like you for always, as long as I'm living, my baby you'll be. The little boy grew. He grew and he grew and he grew. He grew until he was 9 years old, and he never wanted to come in for dinner. He never wanted to take a bath. And when grandma visited, he sometimes said naughty words. Sometimes his mother wanted to sell him to the zoo. But at nighttime, when he was asleep, the mother quietly opened the door to his room, crawled across the floor, and looked up over the side of the bed. If he was really asleep, she picked up that 9-year-old boy and rocked him back and forth. And while she rocked him, she sang, I'll love you forever, I'll like you for always, as long as I'm living, my baby you'll be. The boy grew. He grew and he grew and he grew. He grew until he was a teenager. He had strange friends, and he wore strange clothes, and he listened to strange music. Sometimes the mother felt like she was in the zoo. But at nighttime, when that teenager was asleep, the mother opened the door to his room, crawled across the floor, and looked up over the side of the bed. If he was really asleep, she picked up that great big boy and rocked him back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. And while she rocked him, she sang, I'll love you forever. I'll like you for always. As long as I'm living, my baby you'll be. That teenager grew. He grew and he grew and he grew. He grew until he was a grown-up man. He left home and got a house across town. But sometimes on dark nights, the mother got into her car and drove across town. Really? If all the lights in her son's house were out, she opened his bedroom window, crawled across the floor, and looked up over the side of the bed. If that great big man was really asleep, she picked him up and rocked him back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. And while she rocked him, she sang, I'll love you forever. I'll like you for always. As long as I'm living, my baby you'll be. Well, that mother got older. She got older and older and older. One day she called up her son and said, you'd better come see me because I'm very old and sick. So her son came to see her. When he came to the door, she tried to sing the song. She sang, I'll love you forever. I'll like you for always. But she couldn't finish because she was too old and too sick. And so the son went to his mother. He picked her up and rocked her back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. And he sang this song. I'll love you forever. I'll like you for always. As long as I'm living, my mommy you'll be. When the son came home that night, he stood for a long time at the top of the stairs. Then he went into the room where his very new baby daughter was sleeping. He picked her up in his arms and very slowly rocked her back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. And while he rocked her, he sang, I'll love you forever. I'll like you for always. As long as I'm living, my baby you'll be. Great book. Love reaches out and finds you wherever you are. Love connects us and keeps us together. Love lives on. It never dies. It never stops. Let us pray. Dear Lord, we thank you that we can come to you this morning, that you have opened your arms wide to us, and that you have let us in. We thank you for the love that you share with us. And we pray that your love may find us this week, wherever we are, and that it will help us to keep going. Give us the strength and the encouragement that we need. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Goodbye.
Our scripture this morning comes from the Gospel of John, chapter 14, verses 1 through 14. I'm reading from the New Revised Standard Version. Jesus, the way to the Father. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if we go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, you will know my Father also. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. Philip said to him, Lord, show us the Father, and we will be satisfied. Jesus said to him, Have I been with you all this time, Philip, and you still do not know me? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, Show us the Father? Do you not believe that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me? The words that I say to you I do not speak on my own, but the Father who dwells in me does his works. Believe me that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me. But if you do not, then believe me because of the works themselves. Very truly I tell you, the one who believes in me will also do the works that I do, and in fact will do greater works than these, because I am going to the Father. I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If in my name you ask me for anything, I will do it.
Thank you, Janice, for sharing that powerful story. It brings to life the gospel reading from John chapter 14, which Greg read for us. This section of John's gospel, you may have heard portions of at a funeral or a memorial service, as that section that talks about where Jesus talks about him going to a place and preparing a place for us is a reading that often brings comfort and life and connection to so many people. As we move from life to ultimate life, it reminds us that we will be in the presence of God and of Jesus' love. It's a good text for Mother's Day. And I don't know about you, but as a pastor, Mother's Day has been a challenging holiday to have in the church. There are some church traditions that lift up, that have people stand up, and how many kids do you have? And how many, you know, this and that have you done? And oh, we clap and we're so proud and we're excited. But underneath that, I've actually had people in congregations I've served that would not come to worship on Mother's Day because of that. And many of you may know the very deep reality that mothering or having a mother or trying to be or being a mother can be a very complex thing indeed. And so it is not a religious holiday either. And so even though many churches do a lot of fun stuff around it, it's not in our church calendar. So wherever you are, may you breathe deep. I am thinking of my mom, Linda. She is a retired music teacher and in Abilene, Texas. And her stage of life right now, she's 78. She is residing in a memory care unit in a wonderful facility in Abilene, Texas. And so that's another kind of experiencing something like a Mother's Day, as you remember who not only she is now, but who she was, and consider how we can lift that up in our lives. Jesus gives us an image of mothering in how he tended to his beloved community and says, okay, I've done this, I've said this, you've received it, now go forth, go do it. I mean, think of that mother hen, go on, now it's your turn. to leave the nest and to go and be the church that we have created together. You've been with me, you've heard me, you've witnessed to the power of God's love and grace. Now you go on. And so again, this text was kind of fun to have for a Mother's Day. In verse 9, Jesus says, "Whoever has seen me has seen God. Believe me that I am in God, God is in me." But if you don't, and this word for belief is really like trust. It's not just an intellectual you believe it or not, but it's trust in me. But if you do not, then trust me because of the works themselves, because of what we've been doing, because of what you've seen and experienced and witnessed. And so then he sends us out saying, "You will go and do works that I do, and in fact, will do greater works than these because I am going on to God." So may we receive the blessing and the call of Christ anew this day on this Mother's Day, as the Gospel of John sends us out into the world to do and to be all that Jesus invites us and knows that we can be inside of ourselves. Today, my message is taking a little side turn, but on this Mother's Day, I can't help but lift up the heart-wrenching stories that we are holding right now of a young man who was 26 years old this last Friday. But about 10 weeks ago, on February 23rd, he went out for a jog, and he ended up being followed and shot because he was jogging while black, one might say. So 2 weeks later, two white men, a father and a son, were arrested in the fatal shooting of Ahmaud Arbery. We need to say his name. Ahmaud Arbery. Arbery, excuse me. The men told police they believed he was a suspect in a series of break-ins, but no such crimes were reported in the weeks leading up to the shooting. A heart-wrenching exhibit of our nationalist and racist activity and beliefs and actions that continue to be lived out in our day-to-day lives. My prayer is that the wheels of justice will begin to turn. It took entirely too long, and a message that has been shared says, you know, it wasn't because the police saw the video, it was because we saw the video and responded. And I want to trust in the system, and I just pray that those who are in leadership in the legal system will be able to do what they need to do in this heartfelt, horrific, but all too common reminder that we still live in a time where some of us don't have to blink an eye at going out and going for a jog in a neighborhood, but many others of black and brown skin, that becomes a dangerous endeavor. On this Mother's Day, we are reminded that not every child is safe. Our black and brown children, youth and adults cannot assume they will be safe or protected doing just normal everyday things that I, as a middle-class white female, don't even pay attention to. On this Mother's Day, we are reminded that not every child is safe, that our black and brown children, youth and adults cannot assume that they will be safe or protected doing normal things that I, as a middle-class white woman, don't even pay attention to or think about. There are many who have to think about it every single day when they leave their homes. Jesus weeps at the unnecessary, racially motivated actions that caused the death of one of his beloved children. And now, on this Mother's Day, Jesus calls us brothers and sisters, to not turn away. Because for every story that hits the news, there are many, many that do not. And on this Mother's Day, I would like to share the proclamation. You know, we think of Mother's Day as a time, as a Hallmark holiday. Cards, gifts, balloons, food, celebration. Thanks, Mom, we love you. But Julia Ward Howe was one of the early people to call to celebrate a Mother's Day in the United States. And in 1870, she wrote a Mother's Day proclamation, which was a reaction to the carnage of the American Civil War and the Franco-Prussian War. The proclamation was tied to Howe's conviction that women had a responsibility to shape their societies at the political level. She writes this: "Arise then, women of this day. Arise, all women who have hearts, whether our baptism be of water or of tears. Say firmly, we will not have great questions decided by irrelevant agencies. Our husbands will not come to us reeking with carnage for caresses and applause. Our sons shall not be taken from us to unlearn all that we have been able to teach them of charity, mercy, and patience. We, the women of one country, will be tender of those of another country to allow our sons to be trained to injure theirs. From the bosom of the devastated earth, a voice goes up with our own. It says, disarm, disarm, the sword of murder is not the balance of justice. Blood does not wipe out dishonor, nor violence indicate possession. As men have often forsaken the plow and the anvil at the summons of war, let women now leave all that may be left of home for a great and earnest day of counsel. Let them meet first, as women, to bewail and commemorate the dead. Let them solemnly take counsel with each other as to the means whereby the great human family can live in peace. Each bearing after his own time the sacred impress, not of Caesar, but of God. In the name of womanhood and humanity, I earnestly ask that a General Congress of women without limit of nationality may be appointed and held at some place deemed most convenient and at the earliest period consistent with its objects, to promote the alliance of the different nationalities, the amicable settlement of international questions, the great and general interests of peace." Happy Mother's Day. May we receive Julia Ward Howe's proclamation in the Spirit alongside the Gospel of John, where Jesus says, "You have received what you need from me. Now go and live it. Live the gospel. Be that radical presence of grace and mercy, crossing social boundaries, crossing a male and female, Jew and Gentile. Go." And Julia Ward Howe's heartfelt yearning that women may rise up in times when children and nations are warring. We are still at war within ourselves, within our neighborhoods, our communities, our nation. And so may we take the power of the gospel this day. May we, in this Easter season and on this Mother's Day, on a day of mourning and anguish for the layers of sin in our nation and ourselves, may we receive this gift from Jesus, who loves us, as that book that Janice read, who loves us forever, May we commit ourselves, women, men, young, old, to be seekers of justice. And may we open ourselves to the extravagant and sometimes difficult love of mothering. May we become the very presence and power of Jesus for others this week. Amen. Okay. I invite you to breathe deep as we prepare to pray on this Mother's Day in this season of Easter for ourselves and for others in our midst. Gracious God, for our mothers who have given us life and love, that we may show them reverence and love, we pray to the Lord. For mothers who have lost a child through death, that their faith may give them hope and their family and friends support and console them, we pray to the Lord. For women, though without children of their own, who, like mothers, have nurtured and cared for us, we pray to the Lord. For mothers who have been unable to be a source of strength and who have not responded to their children, have not sustained their families, we pray to the Lord. Loving God, as a mother may give life and nourishment to her children, or others' children, so you watch over us. Bless those who give of themselves through mothering or nurturing or caring for others. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth, and grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them with a spirit of respect. We give you thanks, O God, who is a loving mother and father to us all, and in whose name we pray, as Jesus taught, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Grace United Methodist Church is in mission in numerous ways in our neighborhood, community, and beyond. And the last few weeks, we have lifted up some of the different ways we extend the love of Jesus through our support of ministries that bring help, hope, and healing to others. This week, we lift up our Grace United Methodist facility itself, which opens its doors and to not only various groups within and connected to our congregation and our ministry, but to our community as well, through recovery groups and numerous community groups, therapy groups, and outreach ministries and missions of different kinds. Our boiler just blew, and we have to replace it shortly. It heats the water and the air for the building, which is essential for anyone meeting inside. It is a blessing for us to have a safe and open facility for the variety of ways we can be the church. So I encourage you, I welcome you, we invite you to give your regular pledge or tithe to the church. And if able, we would receive any second mile gifts to the trustees fund, the building fund, to help with this needed project that will need to be done soon. We look forward to prepare our building to receive guests again when it is safe, so we can continue to be a place that people can gather in faith, in wholeness, and in seeking the goodness of life together. Thank you and bless you for your generosity.
Thank you.
And now may we go forth into this beloved day, this day of Easter season, this day of mothers and mothering, this day of somber reflection on a young man whose life was taken far too soon and far too violently and unjustly. May we hold these things and whatever is weighing you down, bringing them to the Spirit of God's grace, that we may go forth being endowed with the strength and the power to go forth as Jesus' beloved community, to bring healing and wholeness to ourselves, to others, in the name of God's beloved community. Grace and peace to you all. Have a good week.